The heart of every man craves a great adventure, but life doesn't usually feel that way. Jesus speaks of narrow gates and wide roads, but the masculine journey is filled with many twists and turns. So how do we keep from losing heart while trying to find the good way when life feels more like a losing battle than something worth dying for? Grab your gear and come on a quest with your band of brothers who will serve as the guides in what we call the masculine journey. The Masculine Journey starts here now.
Welcome to The Masculine Journey. We're so glad that you joined us today. So happy to be here for another week. Guys, we made it through another week. Wherever you're listening from, I know where we are, it's hot. We are in the middle of July here in North Carolina, and it's hot and sticky weather, guys. So, and I told someone the other day, it's hot every July that I've ever been here. It gets hot in July. So that's where we are.
That's why I moved to Boone.
Good reason.
I'm Dennis. Glad to be here hosting today. We've got Andy. We have Jim. And I think we have Robbie on the phone. Robbie, are you with us?
Well, I am. I'm in South Carolina, but I'm with you.
Where are you?
Just outside of Gaffney.
Outside of Gaffney.
Watch for the peach.
Okay.
I've bought already. I'm on my way back from Texas. But we got a heck of a show today.
We do. I thought that Andy said we should ask you for some food a little while ago, but I don't think you're going to make it in time. So we're going to pass on that. Robbie, and guys, I want to ask you a question because we've been talking, actually a few questions. We've been talking about what does a Christian man look like, and we've been doing this for like several weeks now, I think. We're not going to try to count them back today, Jim, because the list is getting lengthy, which is a good thing. I would invite you, if you're listening today and you haven't heard the other segments, to log on to masculinejourneyradio.org, where we have all the podcasts there, and you can go back, and they're all labeled for you. And you can go listen to the different ones. Hopefully what we'll talk about today, if you haven't heard the rest, might entice you to go back and listen to some of those. So, Robbie, I'm going to set this up, and then we're going to play this clip real quick. This was kind of born out of a conversation that you and I had a few weeks ago when I was asking some questions about some things in my future, including going back to graduate school. And we were talking about what that looks like, and I was getting real caught up in what the goals would be. So we thought of some questions, and we're going to kind of throw this out real quick as we begin the program. Is a Christian man goal-driven, you know, setting goals, achieving goals, or is he a climber? Is he performance-based, or is he a journeyman? Is he impatient to get things done, or is he an adventurer, a guy that's going to enjoy the journey? And this goes for women as well. And there was a Christian brother that told me just a couple of days ago that he thought that a lot of Christians have become performance-based in everything that they're doing. It's almost like in some ways we've become worldly with that. And Robbie, you led me to do something, including listen to a song, which I'll let you set this up because we're getting ready to play part of that song in a minute. I'll let you kind of set this up because I'm not going to take responsibility for it. But you can tell us kind of where you went with me.
Being a grandfather and a father, I was subject to watching many episodes of Hannah Montana. And since I was back in those days, I decided to see if I could glean anything meaningful. And in her first movie, Hannah Montana, she did this song called The Climb. And as you were describing your struggle to decide whether or not to go back to graduate school or to pursue this coaching career, I said, well, and I feel this way. You know, which would you enjoy, not the destination, but the journey more? Would you rather be back in school or rather go through the coaching thing? Because, you know, it's like Hannah Montana says, it's all about the climb.
All about the climb.
She looked at me like I was crazy.
So listen.
I said, well, you've never heard the song? And so that there you go. I sent you to listen.
So I went home and listened to it, and this is a part of that song.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there.
All right, so Hannah Montana there was talking about it's the climb, Robbie. She's talking about the journey rather than the destination there, and she was also talking about circumstances. So I'm going to ask one of the guys here, Andy, if you can. Now, you've heard me ask these questions. So when we listen to a song like that and Molly's talking about – Miley, excuse me, Molly. I don't know what to call her, Jim. But Miley's talking about the climb, and – I don't know much of the background of the movie, so maybe we'll get back to Robbie on that in a second. But what does that say to you, and what, as far as the questions that we were asking, where are you with that?
Right. Well, I guess as far as my life, very goal-oriented, like most. And you get to the point where those goals and reaching those goals, there's, you lose the satisfaction. There's some celebration. There's some enjoyment. But a lot of times, okay, what's next? Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I think back. I went on a hike this weekend, the Boone Fork Trail. So I'm walking around it, and I started out just enjoying the scenery and all that. Well, it became, I got to get back, and I get back on time. But, I mean, it was to the goal to finish up. And that's the way we live our lives sometimes, is we don't stop and enjoy it. We take the adventure out of it, as you said earlier, and and it all becomes about the goal, the end destination. And I think it's what God's way of reminding us that, you know, things ultimately aren't going to satisfy here on earth. There'll only be, you know, Him that satisfies here on earth. So,
but Jim, we have a limited time here as Christian men. We have a short period of time, and I've heard some pastors say this. We have a short period of time. We have a lot of work to do. We're going to get an eternity to rest. So we've got to make sure that we get things done. We've got to go make sure that we pass out the tracts. We've got to make sure that we go talk to people. We got to make sure that we get all the programs done in our church that we're supposed to be doing, you know, and we've got a lot of programs and studies and things to do. And you are a pastor. You're on staff at a church. So tell me about that.
Well, I think many of us are put together that way. Mm-hmm. And I look to our best example, and it's Jesus. And Jesus had the ultimate goal of going to the cross. But how many times did he step away from the crowd to be alone with his father? How often did he tell his disciples, you know, when there was somebody interrupting him, that, no, we want to spend time with the children. We want to spend time with this. He never seemed pressed for time, and no man that's ever lived has had a more important goal to attain than he did. So I'm not, I do set goals and I pursue them, but I'm not one that, I prefer the journey to the reaching the point, and then and thinking of it and climbing a mountain. To me, the whole point of climbing the mountain literally is to get to the top and enjoy the view.
Yeah. So, Robbie, one of the things that we talked about, and I want to address because I talked about it with another Christian brother a couple days ago, is that if we're so goal-oriented, we have to get to the top of the mountain, and we're missing the journey along the way, is there a chance that we're missing what God really has in mind for us if we're so focused on that destination?
Yeah. There's about a... That's about a 99% chance on that one, I think.
The ivory soap test?
God is a lot more concerned about what we're becoming than what we accomplish.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, he's probably 100% more concerned about what we're becoming than what we accomplish. And so that journey is, in a way, a sort of initiation into the larger story of what's going on in our life. And if we're outcome-based, then we're in for I don't know about you, but I've noticed a few disappointments on those outcome-based decisions I've made. But if we're, you know, again, again, trying to partner with God through this, realizing that this is initiation, and enjoying that partnership means I'm going to really get a good time, you know, with Christ as I begin to climb. Mm-hmm. And he often puts me on steeper mountains than I would have, I would have ever taken on my own.
But that climb can be rocky. It can be filled with some very difficult circumstances, guys. It's not all easy. It's not all flat path. And we're going to have a clip after the break, I believe, that we're going to kind of address that a little bit. But why go through all those difficult circumstances if we already kind of know what the destination is, Andy?
Well, I think, you know, you don't really have that opportunity to really draw close to God and really allow him to refine you if, first of all, you're getting everything you want and it's coming in at the right time and it's satisfying. You're really not going to depend on him, and you're really not going to be in union with him. So you're going to have to be disconnected from those things. And I look at it as you're really constantly trying to obtain something in the external, where his focus is on the internal and making you who, you know, conforming you to his image. So, yeah, I mean, it just is part of the process. I think a lot of us go through it. We all have the same common fight on a day-to-day basis of whether we're going to choose to go for that goal, and that goal is going to be superior to everything else, or if it's going to be more of, you know, I'm going to enjoy the journey, and I'll pick up some things along the way, but I won't give up my life doing it. It'll be part of the journey.
Wow.
One of the things that just hit me as you were saying that, too, is if we do achieve the goal, even if we do it with God, and that's been part of the journey, when we get there, we are susceptible to the worst sin there is, and it's pride. Look, I've made it. I'm here.
I've arrived.
And if we ever get complacent in that place, we're in trouble.
For sure. Well, we're going to have that other clip when we come back, and I think Jim and I were talking about earlier, he's probably going to be able to set it up for us, because he was talking about having seen part of that movie and knowing a little bit about that clip, so we'll come back to that. Robbie, any other thoughts on this climb scenario? You know, there was something...
Well, you know, I know everybody out there is dying to find out what was Hannah Montana thinking when she wrote this song.
I knew you were going to get to that.
I'm not.
So what was she? Everyone but Jim. So we're gonna address that first.
It was not Miley Cyrus that was singing the song. It was Hannah Montana, and she had gotten way too big for her britches, which is the whole reason that was going on.
Well, evidently that's still going on. We're not sure, but we've heard some better things. We'll be right back after this short break. Stay with us here on the Masculine Journey Radio Show.
Hi, this is Sam with Masculine Journey. I'm here with my son, Eli. We're going to talk about ways that you can help support the ministry. One way, you can go to smile.amazon.com. There's information on our website there on how to do that.
Then you can go to facebook.com, where you can click the donate button. Or you can go to masculinejourneyradio.org. Once again, look for the donate button.
Or if you want to mail something in, mail it to P.O. Box 550, Kernersville, North Carolina, 27285.
Sam, this November boot camp could literally change a lot of men's life. I talk to a lot of men, they're saying...
They say they don't know what their place is in the grand scheme of things. They don't know how to behave as Christian men.
God designed us for freedom, and it's coming up at this boot camp.
It is. Go to masculinejourneyradio.org to register now.
Just $169 early bird pricing for 4 amazing days. Go to masculinejourneyradio.org. Register now.
Welcome back to the Masculine Journey Radio Show. And, guys, that didn't sound at all like Julie Andrews there. That was someone else, I believe. Beautiful song, though. Jim and I were talking both about how much we like that song. We're thinking about it. As usual, our producer, Howard, has come up with something unique for us today, and that was that music bumper. We appreciate that. We're glad that you're back here for the Masculine Journey Radio Show. We're talking about what does a Christian man look like. And is he an adventurer, a climber, a goal setter, an achiever? And this is what I'm going to do. So we've got another clip here. from the movie Into the Wild, I believe, and set that up for us if you can, Jim.
Well, this is a young man who has basically left the life that we all think we're supposed to have. He gave away all of his savings, and he's heading for Alaska on an adventure. And this clip is an encounter he has with an older gentleman, and he has a number of these encounters in the movie. But that really is, he is challenging him to, on a smaller scale, take that same step and still be adventurous.
So he's gotten to, this older guy's gotten to a place where his life is not much adventure there, and he's being challenged to do that. So,
and some of us can identify with that.
Absolutely.
Alaska! Son, what are you running from?
You know, I could ask you the same question, except I already know the answer.
Oh, you do ya?
I do, Mr. Franz. You gotta get back out in the world. Get out of that lonely house, that little workshop of yours. Get back out on the road. Really? You're gonna live a long time, Ron. You should make a radical change in your lifestyle. I mean, the core of man's spirit comes from new experiences. And there you are, stubborn old man, sitting on your butt.
Sitting on my butt?
Yeah.
Ha! I'll show you sitting on my butt. Stubborn old man. I'll show you.
Come on, then. Come on.
Sitting on my butt. Yeah.
Come on, old man. Come climb it.
Sitting on my butt.
Come on, keep going. You're doing great. Keep going. Keep going, Ron.
Yeah.
Can anybody see this? God, are you watching this right now?
Yeah.
You all right?
Ah, I got a little pin head.
So, Robbie, he makes it to the top, and when he said old man there when he started out that, I immediately thought of you. So, so here's a guy that's kind of – and let me get back to that. The young man said, if I recall this correctly, guys, he said the core of a man's soul is in his new experiences, comes from his new experiences. So you've had a lifetime of experiences already. You've had some new experiences in your life, I think things in recent years that you would have never dreamed that God had in mind for you. As a matter of fact, you weren't really that excited. You were more afraid than excited. So take us along that journey a little bit.
Yeah, it gets back to that other episode we did about yielding to God, where, you know, he asked me to get involved in radio, and I didn't know that it would make my heart come alive and how much I would come to love the climb that I'm involved with several things that have to do with radio. And then as I became more aware of what Masculine Journey is doing and the boot camps that we were, my heart really came alive as I got to see freedom in Christ like I'd never seen it before, and the journey got that much more fun, and you know, all sorts of things expanded as my heart came alive. But it started out with that yielding to him and then trusting him on the adventure side of it, and he really did lead me to places I never would have dreamed would have been as much fun as we've had all the last year.
Yeah, so Andy, we go in and out of this in our lives. Do we have to have something like that occur, like Robbie's talking about, be challenged with something new? Do we have new experiences to be challenged with? What I'm thinking about is as Christian men, can we get stuck in a rut of just doing the everyday things? Now, we've got I'm not discounting the fact that we have responsibilities, taking care of ourselves, taking care of our families, earning an income, those things. It's not saying go off into the mountains and live there for the rest of your life, but what's your take on that?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, and I think that's where I had gotten before kind of got interested in the masculine journey message is, you know, I'd been into every ministry and church. I'd been successful in my career. But I just woke up empty, you know, and I knew Jesus, you know, I knew him and he'd spoken to me and I had that relationship, but there were still things in my mind of what gave life, how you could experience life in life. Mm-hmm. And it was dead. And a lot of it was about becoming this nice passive man and not experience an adventure and the part that comes into play and about, you know, brotherhood and really letting yourself get close to other men and brothers and all that stuff, all that, whenever you get those focuses on the things that really are important and the things that God talks about being relationship minded more so than goal oriented, you know, the those things kind of slip away. Now they'll try to creep back in because there's always that push from the world to have, that's just kind of the way we do. It's right. If you haven't got this, you can look at Facebook for 5 minutes and feel like a failure when you look at everybody else's happiness and what they've succeeded in or whatever. So
if they're really being honest.
Well, yeah, that's exactly it.
Jim, you had some thoughts about that before the show, so you had something you want to share, I think.
Well, those thoughts skipped away. So maybe you could remind me of my
We were talking about, and you mentioned about Jesus with the time manager, which I was thinking about a while ago. I read a book that a pastor had out several years ago that said Jesus was probably the worst time manager ever because he was always seeking God's will, so the world's timing did matter to him.
Yeah, and it is a matter of, and one of the things that came to me that I didn't share before, so we're going to go on a tangent. But
okay.
And I'm going to see Michael Card next week in Asheville. But he has a wonderful song that would have also been good for this called mm-hmm. Joy in the Journey. It's the lyrics for a little bit of it. There's a joy in the journey. There's a light we can love on the way. Mm-hmm. There is a wonder and a wildness to life and freedom for those who obey. And that's where I want to jump off of. If we are following God, there is joy in the journey. Mm-hmm. And the outcome is always up to him anyway. Mm-hmm. We don't really, you know, accomplish anything mm-hmm. unless it is done by and through him.
Yeah.
So if we can enjoy the journey, if we can always be present with the people that we're with today and not worry about what we're having to do tomorrow. And Jesus taught us that. You know, mm-hmm. There's enough worry for today. Right. Today. Yeah.
So, Robbie, we have this last clip here that's going to be interesting because it's set in this movie, The Life of David Gale, with a college philosophy professor who's talking to his students about the purpose of life. And normally I wouldn't necessarily recommend that either. I remember the words of Steve Martin years ago. He said that with a college professor, he learned just enough to screw him up for the rest of his life. But I think there's a message here in what may be important in our lives. So let's go ahead and listen to that clip right now.
What is it that you fantasize about? World peace? Thought so. Do you fantasize about international fame? Do you fantasize about winning a Pulitzer Prize or a Nobel Peace Prize, an MTV Music Award? Do you fantasize about meeting some genius hunk, ostensibly bad but secretly simmering with noble passion?
I'll take two.
What was that?
I'll take two.
Kimberly will take two. You get Lacan's point. Fantasies have to be unrealistic. Because the moment, the second that you get what you seek, you can't want it anymore. In order to continue to exist, desire must have its objects perpetually absent. It's not the it that you want, it's the fantasy of it. So desire supports crazy fantasies.
Sorry.
This is what Pascal means when he says that we are only truly happy when daydreaming about future happiness.
He came today.
Or why we say the hunt is sweeter than the kill, or be careful what you wish for. Not because you'll get it, because you're doomed not to want it once you do. So the lesson of Lacan is living by your wants will never make you happy.
What it means to be fully human is to strive to live by ideas and ideals, and not to measure your life by what you've attained in terms of your desires, but those small moments of integrity, compassion, rationality, even self-sacrifice. Because in the end, the only way that we can measure the significance of our own lives is by valuing the lives of others.
Robbie, this comes from a philosophy professor, the significance of our lives, valuing the lives of others. He's not talking about reaching goals. He's talking about what your heart's desire is.
Yeah, it's a it's an eye-opening thing. And he points to some stuff that's right there in everybody's journey. Is they're searching for something, but they don't realize that he's kind of been standing there the whole time waiting on you.
Yeah. And God, guys, the most the worst goal planner and time manager in the universe, because it has nothing to do with any of that, does it, Jim?
How God wants relationship. The Henry Blackaby quote I'd forgotten, I'll throw out here real quick. He was asked at a conference I attended once if he made long-range plans, and his response was, "No, because I'm afraid I would achieve them and never know what God had for me in the journey."
I missed out on what God had, Andy. We thank you so much for joining us for the Masculine Journey radio show today. Got a boot camp coming up in November. Go onto our website to check out that information, and again, to listen to some of our past podcasts. MasculineJourneyRadio.org. You can also look us up, Masculine Journey Radio, on Facebook. Thanks for joining us. We'll talk to you again soon.